If you think calculating reactive power required for power factor correction is a difficult task, then this video will prove you wrong. In this video, I'll be demonstrating you three very simple steps to calculate required reactive power for power factor correction. Also, by the end of this video, you will get a link for a simple Excel tool which you can use to automatically calculate the reactive power. So, to get the details, you need to watch the video. Before moving on in this video, I'll strongly recommend you guys to check out the description of this video. As I have mentioned some of the videos there, you should watch. So before you start calculating the required reactive power, you must know two things. Current power factor of your machine or system, and second is total power in kilowatts. If you know these two parameters, you're good to go. Let's say you have a 100 kilowatt induction motor whose current power factor is 0.7 and you want it to be 0.95. So we will do our calculations to improve the power factor of this motor. The formula which we are going to use is this, where P is equal to total power in kilowatts, Φ1 is equal to current power factor and Φ2 is equal to required power factor. Now we will break this formula in three simple steps. Step 1. Calculate the cos inverse of current and required power factor. Now, in our case, current power factor is 0.7 and required power factor is 0.95. So, the cos inverse of Φ1 is 45.57 and Φ2 is 18.19. So now we will move to our step 2. Multiply the resultant values by tan and then subtract. By doing this, we'll get value equal to 0.6915. Now, the last step, step 3. Multiply the final value by power. Now, in final step, multiply the value obtained from previous step with the power. So, we'll get 69.15 kVAr. So this much amount of reactive power you will need to improve the power factor from 0.7 to 0.95. You can select capacitor banks ranging from 75 kVAr to 80 kVAr to be on safe side. You can also do the same thing using a simple Excel tool that I have created. Simply put the values in kilowatt, current power factor and required power factor in the input field and there you go. You'll get the required reactive power. You will find the link for this tool in the description of the video. So if you want the Excel tool, you can go to that link and simply hit download. If you found the video helpful, do share it with your friends. Do subscribe to my YouTube channel for future updates. You can also visit my website www.theelectricalguy.in for more videos and articles about electrical engineering. That's all for this video. I'll see you guys in my next one. Till then, keep watching, keep learning.